Hello, everyone. My name is Christine Lee. I'm the Assistant Dean and Chief Marketing Communications Officer at UCLA Samuel A. School of Engineering. Thank you so much for inviting me to speak with you. I'm asked to share a little bit about the COVID protocol that's currently in place at the school and also on campus. So first of all, I hope all of you are keeping safe and are well. This pandemic has been really difficult for many of our constituents, our students, faculty, loved ones. So just wanted to share a little bit about the protocols, and please understand that we are doing our best to keep up with county health experts in terms of what the latest numbers of cases and information they share. And then obviously campus will make determination on what needs to be done in order to help curb the spread of COVID. So there's a lot of confusion and misinformation. We do our best to catch up. Usually when campus were to send out a new guidance as to what they wish to change, I, as the head of the engineering communications unit, will get a heads up. And right away, I will ask my team to make the necessary changes on our COVID information page. So I just want to begin by sharing with you as to where you find the page, because I get asked a lot about where do we find the various campus websites? And it's because of that reason, we decided that we will be the one to actually pull all the information from various sources on campus and put it in one place for your convenience. What we do is we don't make up these rules by no means. We actually collect information from campus websites and then pull it together and sort of do this QA type of format and put it on our COVID information page, which can be accessed directly on our homepage. Is, as you can see, right under the banner image, you'll be able to see there, this is banner about our COVID page, and it can be found any department homepage. It doesn't matter where, which department you're visiting. You will find the same information page access point underneath the main banner image. So from that, if you take a look, once you click on it, we try to break down the information based on the relevance to the various constituents. So you will find sort of campus-wide type of questions first regarding testing, regarding quarantine, regarding face mask use, and then you will find the more specific breakdown by groups, such as faculty and students and staff. And then once you get into the page, if there's any particular question that somehow is not addressed, please do feel free to reach out to my unit, and I will share with you the best way to get in touch with us after the presentation during the Q&A. But right now, I just want to make sure that you know, if you can spend some time visiting that page, you will find where all the relevant information is. And then you can then go back from time to time to get update, because in general, we are at least within 24 hours of a new brewing post. With new information, new protocols, new guidelines. I remember we went through several such revamping of protocols last year and earlier this year, but in general, we're able to update our page within 24 hours, and usually much faster than that. So once you're on that page, I know particularly of interest to this group is how we do events. What are some of the guidelines for students hosting events? And I wanted to make sure that you know that this is constantly evolving. So what I tell you today in August may not hold once the fall starts. So I wanted to make sure you constantly go back to our page to check for updates. But for now, when you go to the webpage under university status right here, you will see these questions are relevant to holding events. What are some of the guidelines? So I pull some relevant ones, the big picture ones, because I know that most people come to me and ask questions about face masks. You know, are we on or off? So for now, until further notice, face masks are actually mandatory. It's not optional when you're indoors on campus. That just means that, you know, because of the uptick in the number of cases in the region, we as a university wanted to make sure we do our part to help curb the spread of a COVID-19 virus. So just want to make sure that you know, coronavirus. So I just want to make sure that you know, face mask is absolutely, and it's a well-fitting one, and we do not encourage people to wear the cloth ones. So either the surgical mask, K95, whatever you can get. And there are various campus points that are dispensing these face masks for free. So that information again can be found on that page as to where you can get the face mask. But wearing a well-fitting face mask right now is mandatory indoors. It is optional outdoors. However, I really suggest if you're in a crowded place, there's not enough room for social distancing, you are obviously encouraged to continue to wear a mask, because there are going to be places where you're just really, really crowded. So that's really something for your own safety and for the safety of others. Then the second most frequently asked question is, what about the symptom monitoring survey? Are we still doing that? The answer is yes. We are required to fill out the daily symptom monitoring survey. I think a lot of you are doing this on the phone. Some of you still doing it on the website and do a printout, or some of you just do a screen grab, however it's most convenient to you. The clearance is required for UCLA faculty, staff, and students, and also attendees who regularly come to the campus, which means these could be contract workers or students who are taking classes on campus. So for those regular visitors, they are also required to fill out the symptom monitoring survey. However, it is not required for just casual visits, people coming by campus, you know, go to the restaurants, go walk around. It's not required for them. We are leaving it to individual groups' judgment as whether when they host events, if you wish to implement the symptom monitoring survey, it is completely up to you. So each group can decide within your own group, among your membership, leadership, whether you want to implement a pre-entry check of the symptom monitoring survey. It is not required by the university. So we, from the administration side, we're not saying that you must do it or you don't do it. It is absolutely up to you whether you wish to implement. Some groups do it, some groups don't, simply because sometimes the event is just there's no extra resource or someone who can be designated as someone to check the symptom monitoring survey. So it's again up to individual groups to decide. Then we're going to talk a little bit about the weekly surveillance testing. I think a lot of us become very familiar with, you know, it's in a vending machine, the swab sick test. We actually is invented by our faculty members, both from UCLA Health and also from our own professors of computational medicine, which is a part of UCLA Health and also affiliated with the School of Engineering. So we're very proud of the test, which has really helped our faculty, students, and staff keep up with their testing. It is no longer required. However, if you, for peace of mind, or if you feel like you have been exposed to someone who resides in the same place with you, you're absolutely encouraged to continue to do the testing. It is still available using your Bruin card. It's free for you to get the test from the vending machine and continue to test. It is no longer required. So I wanted to make that clear. I get a lot of questions about food. Is it okay to serve food and drink beverage when we're on campus at events? The short answer is yes. You are actually right now allowed to serve food and beverage for an indoor event, outdoor, of course, as well. However, having said that, given the number of cases and with fall coming, winter, we are expecting the number to unfortunately probably going to rise again. So as of now, campus asks that you consider serving your food in the outdoor area, or if you must serve food indoor, please consider the capacity of the room. Make sure people can actually spread out so they have proper space for themselves when they have to remove the mask to eat. And then consider having something that people can just grab and go and not have to necessarily sit at a certain place or be served with the food, or have to, if you're serving a buffet style indoor, then it increases the chances of people having to be in close proximity to get their food. So consider box lunches, so people can just take the food and maybe go outside to eat, and then come back to your meeting. So again, a lot of it, this is evolving and it's fluid. So I encourage you to, from time to time, if you're not sure what the latest update is and you may have missed a brewing post, just come back to our site. We again try to update it as quickly as we can, as soon as we get the heads up from campus leadership. We will update this page that again you can access from various websites. So I hope this is helpful, and I'm here to address questions if you have any. So with that, I'm going to stop sharing and I will end this presentation. Thank you.